Namaskar. On behalf of Global Kashmiri Pandit Diaspora, I welcome you all to the first of a series of webinars we are hosting to commemorate our genocide and forced exodus on 19th January 1919. On this day, as you all know, and in the days leading up to this, thousands of Kashmiri Pandit community members and other members of innocent members of society were killed by terrorists, and lakhs were made homeless. Lakhs like you and me were rendered homeless and rootless, and we are now spread across the world. So there was a pogrom of violence unleashed against us, and 32 years later, justice is still eluding us. Over the next 7 days, GKPD has invited a host of eminent members from a wide spectrum of society. We have invited politicians, lawmakers, members of civil society and journalists, and also, most importantly, family members of victims of genocide. So we will be talking about a host of topics related to us and related to our community. So please join and share and comment on our Facebook page. On that note, I would like to pass on to today's moderator, Shri D.K. Bakshiji. D.K. Bakshiji is GKPD coordinator for Thailand and a very eminent businessman and HR advisor. So over to you, Bakshiji.
Namaskar. First of all, let me thank Dr. Shefalika Kotwal Ban, our international coordinator, GKPD UK, to be here this evening and kicking off this series of this webinar. Dr. Shefalika is one of our very super human power of GKPD, who has been consistently working for GKPD mission along with other volunteers. You can see many volunteers, and I, especially for this series, Ajay Chaudhary ji from GKPD Germany, Virender Kohl from Fiji, now in India, of course, Ash Rana from Brisbane, Vidya Bhushan, there from Toronto, and many others. And of course, above all, our chief volunteer, Dr. Surinder Kohl, based out of Houston, who are the driving force for this series. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm here to welcome all of you as participants of Kashmiri Pandit community, non-Kashmiri Pandit community in India, and international community who are watching this webinar now or will be watching later. First of all, let me respect our Indian Army, as today is Indian Army Day. Our greatest respect to this great army of the world to keep us safe. Having said that, we are here to discuss and deliberate a very tragic, unheard ethnic cleansing of a very simple, cultured, educated Kashmiri Pandit community, which we belong to, who had great roots in Kashmir Valley, thousands of years. Today, in any part of the world, anywhere, whether somebody is in Chicago, or somebody is in Calcutta, or somebody is in New Delhi, or somebody is in New York, each and every Kashmiri Pandit must be in agony, because this week, 15th January, up to this 19th January, this week is such a dreadful week for all of us that we may not be even sleeping during nights. Those messages, those loudspeaker messages must be still haunting all of us. And in fact, must be haunting those who have left us, who had never left Kashmir Valley, and they had to leave Kashmir Valley and go to other parts of the country. And even there, they must be literally looking what is gone to this community. And especially when we look that this week must be a very painful week for those families, especially those who lost their people. in a place which is highest and largest democracy in the world, Bharat Desh, unbelievable. But it is a fact that radical Islamization created this. And the worst part of this was the entire government of India, state governments around the country, the media kept everything under carpet. No one could even talk about this. This is so painful. This is so dreadful that a community which was known as the patriotic community and who were living peacefully, even after 32 years, we have not taken guns in hand. Even after 32 years, we are cultured, educated, and we are around the world. Nobody could even think for decades about this community. The media kept this totally under the carpet. The governments which were there were completely, you know, not affected what is going on in the world. And this made us more painful. Can there be such tragic moments of life, unheard, unknown, unbelievable? Probably not. This is a true fact of life, that a community of teachers, rishis, who were brutally acted by the radicalization of Islamization, which started, I need not, because there are many great speakers who will be sharing, which started 70 years back when Kabali raid started on 22nd October 1947, left all of us unaware, and we had to move to different parts of the country. So when I look at this month of January, and especially this week, it is painful, it is dreadful, and each of the Kashmiri Pandits will never, ever, never, ever forget 19th January 1990, Relu Seluya Galu. Today, ladies and gentlemen, I have with me a very esteemed panel of speakers. I have with me a politician. He is a BJP leader. He's our community leader, respected Ashwini Changusa. I have with me Sumit Peersa, well-known name from the corporate world and who has done great job, and today he's a political analyst. I have with me our own community IGP Saab, Inspector General of Police, Yogendra Kaur Saab, and we have with us ex-Director General of Police, UP, Dr. Vikram Singh. And of course, we will be joined by Madam Subuhi Khan. She is a Supreme Court lawyer and a very strong social activist. The subject is very important. Kashmiri Pandit genocide, blot. It's a scar. It's a blot. It's a severe scar. It can never go from our lives. And I always say it can never go from any Kashmiri Pandit who is yet born. Because a Kashmiri Pandit who is yet born will always be known as a Kashmiri Pandit. And this is a blot on the secularism and democracy. The subject, Kashmiri Pandit genocide, blot on secularism and democracy. That is the subject today. And I would have a format wherein each of the speaker will be speaking for 7 minutes and give their viewpoints. And then we will have questions, some of the questions I have in my mind. And we would certainly like to take some questions, those who write on the Facebook. And we will take some questions from Facebook as well and try to get responses on that. So with those little background, first of all, I am trying to invite our KP leader, Kashmiri Pandit leader, community leader, and a BJP leader, Ashwini Changusa, who has been a very strong activist, and he has been in the forefront last 3 decades, doing fantastic, excellent work for the community. In fact, he has been leading our genocide story at National Human Rights Commission, NHRC. And he is a great author and columnist. We see him regularly writing on the topics with a matter of substance. His continuous focus on NHRC has led to some of the universities to create the program in their studies, the case study of Kashmiri Pandits. So that's one of a very great things today. When children go to the universities, they have a case study of Kashmiri Pandit genocide. May I request Ashwiniji to share your thoughts, and then we will come back to you. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Bakshi Sahab. Am I audible? Am I audible, please?
Yes, sir. You're audible.
Okay. The distinguished panel here, thank you very much for this opportunity that has been granted by the Global Kashmiri Pandit Diaspora. They have been doing a wonderful job. I have been linked with it over the last 3 to 4 years. Wonderful job doing at wonderful places. And particularly what they did the last year in regard to the Festival of Kashmir, and also in regard to organizing genocide-related activities in and outside India. That is a remarkable work that they did. I was right today addressing a seminar on In Pursuit of Peace, Improving Indo-Pak Relations. It is actually a group that is working for peace between India and Pakistan. They had gone for a webinar today. It was a very huge kind of a webinar attended by many important people, including the former Foreign Minister of Pakistan, Khurshid Mohammad Qusuri. Khurshid Mohammad Qusuri, in his inaugural speech, said that there are certain worrying facts about India. And he said that recent Dharm Sansad resolution and those addresses and speeches therein spoke about the so-called genocide of Muslims in India. Then he went on with his own perception of the things. But when he had to conclude lastly in the program, I told him that I would like to intervene and would like to add something that he has referred to. I made it known to him through my intervention that when he is talking in terms of some fringe elements coming up in India and talking about the so-called genocide of Muslims in India, he should better go into the genesis of those fringe elements, the reasons why these fringe elements have come up in India, why there are growing fringe elements like those in India. I said it is because there is a pent-up feeling for the last 30 to 40 years that if something has happened very bad with the Hindus, there has not been an appropriate response. There has not been an appropriate response on behalf of the society, on behalf of the government, and even on behalf of the institutions that were created to do so. As an example, I said that there is a case of genocide of Kashmiri Pandits in Kashmir, whose ethnic cleansing is a fact of history, a fact of life. And by today, say after 35 years of the happening, at least if there would have been nothing, there could have been one thing, at least that was the establishment of a tribunal kind of a thing, tribunal court like a thing, that would have gone into the issues connected with the genocide and ethnic cleansing of Kashmiri Pandits. And that would have set an example for others as well. I told him that, and for the purpose of this webinar also, it is very pertinent to note that during the last elections, we must be knowing that Sam Pitroda came from USA to campaign for Congress. And in his whimsical way, he said about what happened to Sikhs in 1984, quote, unquote, hua to hua. If that is a concept of, if something happens to some kind of a people, some kind of community, and then we say about it, hua to hua, is this also likely to be said about Kashmiri Pandit, hua to hua? This nation needs to reply that. This society, this government needs to say whether it is what was done to Kashmiri Pandits, a way of life for them, or what has happened to Kashmiri Pandits was an aberration. In my opinion, it should have been an aberration, but it happened. I took this case along with my colleagues, along with my companions, to the National Human Rights Commission in 1994, when National Human Rights Commission had been set up by virtue of the Human Rights Act of 1993. And fortunately for me and for all our colleagues, the National Human Rights Commission, the then National Human Rights Commission, headed by Justice Ranganath Mishra and then by Justice Vetachalaya, they constituted commission of inquiry. They constituted the commission's court. And Mr. P.N. Lekhi, a senior advocate of Supreme Court and the Delhi High Court, advocated our case without any cost. And then the decision of the National Human Rights Commission came in 1999 saying that acts akin to genocide have been committed against Kashmiri Pandits. Quote, they also said that genocide type design may exist in the mindset utterances of terrorists and militants in Jammu and Kashmir against Kashmiri Pandits. And they also said, quote, that due understanding and relief have not been given to Kashmiri Pandits for what has been done to them, and so on and so forth. What I mean to say here is that despite what National Human Rights Commission said, the then government could not take this National Human Rights Commission's decision to a logical conclusion. And all the
We lost you. We can't hear you. Ashwiniji, we can't hear you. Are you there? Hello. I think there is something wrong with Chungu Saab's internet connection. Can you hear me? Can you others hear me? Peer Saab, can you hear me? Okay. Yes, you.
I can hear you.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, so Chungu Saab, are you there or we lost you? Oh, we lost him. Okay. In the meanwhile, till we get Chungu Saab back, I think we need to move further. That's the issue of digitalization. So we can't be dependent completely. And especially in Jammu, there could be an issue in Patoli area where he stays. Let me introduce the next speaker in the meanwhile. Let me go to the youngstan of our Kashmiri Pandit community. Person called Sumit Peer Saab, very young professional with a huge background globally in the corporate world. And today, I mean, he never wanted to have any other passport, and he wanted to be back in India, Bharat Mata. And today, when you look at him, he is a very well-known political commentator, opinion maker on various talk shows and debates. More than around 2,000 debates he must have conducted, be it NewsX, Times Now, CNN18, Republic, Aaj Tak, you name it, he is there. he's very critically outspoken insights have been of national and political interest in the country and globally. And especially when he is having discussions with Pakistani channels, which makes a very impactful point of view by Sumit. Sumitji, you have another 7 minutes for you to share your thoughts, and we will try to get Changusha back in the meanwhile. Over to you. All yours, Sumitji.
First of all, thank you very much, Bakshi Sam, and namaskar to all of you. It's a pleasure, it's an honor, and it's a lifetime achievement to be on this panel, because this is something which is close to the heart. It is more than what you have done in your life, because your heart and mind both sink here. That is the first point I want to say. I want to thank you. I can't thank you more for giving me this opportunity, sir. So let me start. The first thing is, you know, we have seen events which have passed in our lives, and there are some events, there are some occurrences which leave a resonating effect, which literally, if I can say, they cast their image on the sands of time. And Kashmiri Pandit exodus, genocide, and ethnic cleansing, they're synonyms in this matter, is one such event. And this all happened not in the time of Aurangzeb. This didn't happen in the time of Babur. This didn't happen when the time in the history was not written. This happened 30 years back, when all of us, most of us watching this show, were born and we were live and kicking. We could realize this happening. This happened in 21st century. This happened in the biggest democracy of the world. This happened in the largest democracy of the world. And this happened under the watchful eye of the world, and not a stone moved. That is the tyranny of the time. That is the time we live in. That is what we have faced. Let me take you back a moment in the history, and let's try to put the pieces together. What really happened? If you remember that point of time, the USSR broke up. There was a revolution in Romania. Few Islamic countries were born. Chechnya, Azerbaijan, Armenia, Kazakhstan. So there were people, there were powers who got a clue from there. What if we let the Kashmiri Pandit out? By the way, Kashmiri Pandit is the Kashmiri Hindu, as 99% of the Kashmiri Hindus were Pandits. So we call Kashmiri Pandit. It is only against Brahmins, or it's only against Pandits. It was against all the Hindu. The idea was ethnic cleansing, and that is what was the Mughal motive was. By ethnic cleansing and making this place a 100% Muslim populated place, it will qualify accordingly to Armenia, Azerbaijan, Kazakhstan. That was that model in work. And if I can be candid and direct with you, there was one more theocratic concept which was in the mind of these perpetrators for thousands of years, that is Ghazwa-e Hind. Excellent opportunity, have a fusion, make Armenia, Azerbaijan like case study, ethnic cleansing, and Ghazwa-e Hind. And where all to start from, which is the best place in the planet Earth. Hazaron saal se yehi hasrat dil mein rahi hai, par tab aane karne ka mauka mila. It was done in Kashmir. So who was the villain? Who was the perpetrator? Who was the enemy? The enemy was who has been your ancestor. And let me take you back. The grandfather of great Farooq Abdullah was a Kashmiri Pandit, and the great grandfather of so secular intellectual leader was Kashmiri Pandit, which you will never accept. But that is historical fact. You cannot run away from it. So these people, along with Pakistani terrorists, and along with the people in power in the state and wherever they matter, they got together, a cabal was formed. This cabal had one objective, one clear objective, ethnic cleansing. Now the problem is, you are a 500,000 people. By 5 lakh loko kaise bagai? How will you get rid of 500,000 people? How many bullets, how many guns will you need? The only weapon is genocide. Start killing people ruthlessly. Find excuse. Kill somebody in a gunny bag of coal. Kill somebody in front of his wife in a drum or a barrel of rice, and send them message, hang them, put the posters, use the newspapers. And if somebody tells me this happened without the government of the day knowing it, this happened without the government of the day being hands and gloves over it, will be utter BS. Sorry to use that word, sir, but this is utter bullshit. It happened with their full knowledge, and this was happening under the watchful eye of then the government of India. The whole world was watching, and it was happening. This drama, this scandal of destruction was happening blatantly. Newspapers, hoardings, banners, everything was done. So started killing people, killing women, raping women, abducting children, killing all the prominent people. And the youngsters of the community was to send that wave of paranoia, which will send you backpacking. And exactly that's happened. The government of the day decided not to act. The army was there, and if they would, this would have been prevented. This cannot happen today. This happened that time because they all said, keep your eyes closed, because Ghazwa-e Hind had started forming, and nobody dared to intervene in that. That is the reality of life. So what happens next? the exodus happens and we are thrown out of our roots. We are left high and dry in camps of Jammu to die. So you can be a bait of a snake or you can be a bait of the sun. You decide your destiny, you decide your fate. That is what you're destined to do. And this is done by somebody who has been, whom you share the common DNA with. They were all converted Kashmiri Pandits who did this. And this could have not been done without the government of the Delhian hand and gloves. Now this history is done. This is done, kept under the carpet, given some 2,000, 3,000, 1,000 rupees so that you can survive. You don't have mass, you don't want to look it like a mass murder. Let it be like that. Let it be like, let them survive. Let them be on their own. And what is your mistake? Aapki galti kya saab? Your mistake is you're Hindu and you're patriotic. You're a patriotic Hindustani. Isiliye aapko nikala gaya. Aur aapki koi galti nahi. That is the only mistake. So they got your property. They got your everything. And they made this into a 100% Muslim circle of influence, and that is what the objective was. Now what next? Now this happened, but by the grace of God, being educated and being those fighters by nature, we never conceded, we never picked up a gun, we never went begging for anything. And by the grace of God, today we're everywhere in the world and we are addressing this forum on the India, on the soil of India and across the whole world. So let me go and ask them, what have you created? What have you got? The answer is nothing. We are much bigger, much brighter, much taller and much resilient today. And we will continue this for next 100 years. There is no way you can bring us down. I have to make this amply clear to you, whoever you are. And let me bring this one more question, which brings to my notice, is we have an eminent person here. Great. Bakshi ji. Today, the tyranny of the time is that Mr. Bakshi cannot talk about Kashmir. Kashmir to unka hai nahi. But Farooq Abdullah and Umar Abdullah will decide what will happen in Kashmir. Umar Abdullah will say, if I give you a piece of land for putting a tent outside Shri Amarnath Ji Gupa, ecology kharab hoti hai. And let me tell you one more fact. It is Mata Vaishno Devi Shrine, which has been the biggest contributor to the state of J&K. Jo tankhai chalti hai, jo gaadiyon mein petrol dalta, uske paise Mata Vaishno Devi Shrine se aate hai. This was never told to anybody. When the money was going from state, 90% goes to Kashmir, 8% to Jammu, 2% to Leh. That is the religious discrimination which was happening there. And now what do? We have faced that. We have faced the genocides of Kushtikar. Now the time is there for us. The time is for the government of India. The time is, do you want 100 years, 200 years down the line, when I may not be there, you may not be there, somebody else will be there. What will you tell your kids? A bunch of boys, 400 or 500 with Russian old Kalashnikovs and some old secondhand bullets from the Russian era could come and dismantle the might of India and boom, and dismantle the Republic of India from Kashmir, could take out a Kashmiri Hindu patriot and let him be his on his own and fend on his life in across the world. Those who survived, because we are resilient, I'm proud of that. But is this the story you are going to take? Or do we have the courage to change the clock of the time? The need of the hour is to change the clock of the time and not live with what happened in the past, because past is past and I can see that happening. I want to make five tangible, to cut the long story short, sir. I want to make five tangible things here, five tangible demands. First thing, demand, agree, and we should declare it as a genocide. Let the world know, let the people know there was a genocide. Point number two, constitute a war crimes tribunal. And this is what I've been saying for years across all channels. Create a war crimes tribunal so that people like Yasin Malik and Bitta Karat and all, why they're still breathing in free India, I don't understand. They should be 3 feet down the ground. Why they're still breathing, that is a blot on you and me, and we continue to live, and 1.3 billion Indians continue to live when they admitted they killed people in Border Elect. And let me remind you, seven of them were men wearing the Indian Air Force uniform. They had emblem on their chati. They were murdered in Rawalpura. Let's not forget that. The point number three is, all the sales which happened of Kashmiri Pandit property should be declared embargo, blanket distress sales, and the people should be compensated as per present market prices. Point number four, if Israel-based kind of settlement is the answer, let us have an Israel kind of settlement. Let's send a message to Pakistan and those jihadis and those supporters. You cannot take the might of India. The land belongs to us. The land belongs to me. The land belongs to you and belongs to everybody. Aaj Kashmir kisi ke baap ka nahi hai. Kashmir belongs to 1.3 billion Indians. And the last thing I want to demand, have a chapter in the history, because teach your next generations what happened there, because the people who do not respect history will never have a bright future. Jews wrote their history. Germans did what they did. They wrote their history because this is the only way to ensure it never ever happens again. Aur hum aaj the, hai aur rahenge, aur Ishwar ki Mahadev ki kripa se hum isse bade honge, because it is the land of Shiva and Mahadev. Don't forget that. Shiv se bas badi hasti to kisi ki na thi, na hai, na hogi. Koshish karte rehna, sadiyon guzar jayegi. Generation
निकल जाएगी, हम वही थे हैं और रहेंगे। हाँ, Peer Sahib, you made me emotional this evening. And what a thought process. What a beauty of thoughts you could present. And people say that we keep on repeating what has happened, but we still need to keep repeating. We still need to keep hammering. We still need to keep doing this. Because 32 years, no one could listen to us. It's only last 7 years people have started looking at us. And people are now watching what is going on. I just came from US. I went to see the movie called Kashmir Files. We were crying there. And people were crying, not from our community, the other communities, the Indian community, the global community, when they could see what has happened to our community. And that's a fact of life. That is the true story of genocide. When you're rightly asking for certain demands, which we will be coming and talking further. Thank you very much for your contribution. Very impactful, very meaningful thought process. We have Shogu Sahib back now. Is he back? Ashwani ji, you can go back. You have another couple of minutes because then I go to the next speaker. Ashwani ji, you can go ahead. You have to unmute your microphone, please.
Yes, I believe I was talking about when the disconnection came forward. I was actually at that point of time talking about that Kashmiri Pandits have a bigger say now in the changed circumstances, that if it can happen with Kashmiri Pandits and it happened with them some 30 years before, it could happen to any sort of people, any community, anywhere in India. And it is basically the Kashmiri Pandit is a case that needs to be sorted out today or tomorrow. And I believe when somebody says that what has happened to India and in what way you are, what has happened to in Kashmir regarding Kashmiri Pandits, and in what way say you are saying that it's a blot on democracy and secularism of India. I have an answer. कि democracy और secularism पर आखिर blot कैसे है ये? जब कश्मीरी पंडितों के साथ जो कुछ किया गया वो blot नहीं है, तो फिर blot क्या है? Blot तो ये है कि उनके मारने वाले आज भी जिंदा हैं, आज भी वो घूम फिर रहे हैं, और उसके बाद भी अगर हम या हम में से कोई कहे कि कश्मीरी पंडितों के साथ जो हुआ सो हुआ, बात खत्म हो गई, कल ये किसी के साथ हो सकता है. इट कैन हैपन विद एनीबॉडी. एंड कश्मीरी पंडित इज केस वेयर वी विल हैव टू सेटल इट फॉर ऑल द टाइम्स टू कम, कि ऐसा होना जो है वो और किसी के साथ नहीं होगा. बहुत बार ऐसा हमने देखा है कि किसी के साथ तो होता है लेकिन बाकी सबक ले लेते हैं. उसके लेसन्स जो हैं, जो कश्मीरी पंडितों के साथ हुआ है, ये एक प्रकार का लेसन है. केवल ये सोचना कि हम सरकार बदल देंगे, या ये सोचना कि हम कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन में कुछ अमेंडमेंट्स करेंगे, ये काफी नहीं है. काफी तब है जब हम जिनके साथ जो हुआ है उसका उनको खमियाजा दें, नंबर वन. नंबर टू, टू सेट राइट व्हाट हैज बीन ऑलरेडी डन रॉन्ग. ये चीजें होती हैं जिससे हमने देखा होगा न्यूरमबर्ग ट्रायल्स में क्या हुआ था. जापान के लिए अमेरिका को माफी मांगनी पड़ी थी, और ये जो इतिहास में हुआ है ये कोई रोक नहीं सकता. इन द सेंस कि जब हम ये कहते हैं कि कश्मीरी पंडितों के साथ ये हुआ है, अगर कोई इसमें ये सोच रहा है कि जो हम कह रहे हैं हम पुराने जख्म जो हैं उनको कुरेद रहे हैं, मैं तो ये कहूंगा ये जख्म रिश्ते रहने चाहिए. इन जख्मों से खून तब तक बहते रहना चाहिए जब तक ये जख्म बढ़ नहीं जाएंगे. नहीं तो सारा देश एक दिन हम देखेंगे ये सारा देश जख्मी हो जाएगा. आज कश्मीरी पंडितों ने अपने शरीर पर, अपनी आत्मा पर और अपने विचारों पर ये सारे जख्म तो ले लिए हैं, लेकिन हमने ये इसलिए लिए हैं कि हम सारे देश को इन जख्मों से बचाएं। इन जख्मों से सारे देश को बचाने के लिए कश्मीरी पंडितों ने ये जख्म अपने ऊपर लिए हैं, लेकिन मामला यहीं समाप्त नहीं होता। मेरी आप सबसे प्रार्थना है कि इस तरह के कार्यक्रम करके सारी दुनिया में इस बात को पहुंचाएं कि हमारे साथ जो हुआ है, इट इज नाइदर टू बी फॉरगॉटन नॉर टू बी फॉरगिवन, नाइदर इट विल बी फॉरगॉटन नॉर इट विल बी फॉरगिवन, एंड वी विल टेक दिस इशू टू द प्लेस वेयर इट शुड बी टेकन। और सबसे बड़ी बात, आज का माहौल बदल गया है। आज का माहौल आज से 30-35 साल पुराना माहौल नहीं है। उस समय हमें सुनने वाले लोग नहीं थे, कश्मीर फाइल्स को बनाने वाले लोग नहीं थे, आज ऐसे लोग सामने आ गए हैं। काश उस वक्त विक्रम सिंह जी जैसे ब्यूरोक्रेट और आईपीएस ऑफिसर उन स्थानों पर होते जहां पर मामला उनका फैसला हो जाता था, लेकिन ऐसा नहीं था उस समय। लेकिन अब बदल गया है, माहौल बदल गया है। हमने उस बदले हुए माहौल में अपनी पोजीशन को और मजबूत करके अपनी बात को सामने रखना चाहिए, और उसमें यह ध्यान रखना चाहिए कि जब हम ये ऐसा कर रहे हैं या कह रहे हैं, हम देश को आगाह कर रहे हैं कि आज जो हमसे हमारे साथ हुआ है, कल वही आपके साथ होगा, भगवान न करे। थैंक यू वेरी मच, सो काइंड ऑफ यू।
अश्विनी जी, थैंक यू सो मच फॉर योर वंडरफुल थॉट्स, एंड दैट इज अ फैक्ट ऑफ लाइफ दैट इन केस टुडे एंटायर कंट्री डज नॉट अंडरस्टैंड द पेन of Kashmiri Pandits, what we have gone through. And this zakham bilkul aapka ke sath agree kar rahe hain Ashwini ji, ye zakham bilkul dikhne chahiye, ye zakham bilkul hammering effect mein puri duniya mein phailana chahiye ki hua kya hai. main aapko bata raha hu, ye Anjali Raina abhi Facebook pe hai, isko dekh ke jab husn aaye aise gale mili to roye hum, main roya, Anjali roi, because direct victim hai. और ये विक्टिम्स जो है हमें सामने लाके, आई एम सो थैंकफुल एंड ग्रेटफुल टू ग्लोबल कश्मीरी पंडित डायस्पोरा व्हिच हैज गिवन अस सच अ पावरफुल प्लेटफॉर्म ऑफ टेलिंग द वर्ल्ड व्हाट हैज हैपेंड, ऑफ मेकिंग आवर वॉइस हर्ड एनीवेयर इन द वर्ल्ड। एंड आई फुली एग्री विद अश्विनी जी दैट अब एक ऐसी परिस्थिति बन रही है, एक ऐसा टाइम आया है जहां हमारी थोड़ी सी सुनवाई है, जहां पीपल आर रिस्पेक्टिंग अस एंड गिविंग अस अपॉर्चुनिटी टू टॉक। सो देयर इज अ चेंज ऑफ अ बिग चेंज हैपेंड इन द कंट्री। एंड अश्विनी जी, थैंक यू सो मच, एंड आई वुड लाइक टू नाउ गो टू आवर ओन कश्मीरी पंडित IGP साहब, एंड आई वुड टेल यू अगेन अ डायरेक्ट विक्टिम। इनफैक्ट आई एम टोल्ड कोल साहब वॉज वर्किंग इन कपवारा ड्यूरिंग दिस मंथ ऑफ जनवरी, and even he did not know this family has shifted to Jammu. वो कपवारा में अपनी ड्यूटी कर रहे थे and उसकी फैमिली जम्मू भाग गई थी, he did not even know. Now you can understand the pain, the person is on the job fighting for the country and he is fighting with militants, उसकी अपनी श्रीनगर से अपनी फैमिली जम्मू भी पहुंच गई, इनको पता ही नहीं। A very well known IGP of the J&K State, who started in 1985, and he has been, he has obtained PG in human rights history. He has worked on anti-terrorism training, crime investigation, and in fact, he has been at UN police mission in Bosnia, and he has received President of India Award, Distinguished Service Medal, Meritorious Service Medal, many medals, UN Peace मेडल, जेके डीजीपी मेडल। मैं रिक्वेस्ट करूंगा IGP कोल साहब से आप अपने पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू इसी तरह से 7 मिनट्स में रखिएगा। ओवर टू यू सर, फ्लोर इज योर्स सर।
नमस्कार महाराज, माय रिगार्ड्स टू ऑल द रेस्पेक्टेड पैनलिस्ट्स। सिंस द प्रोग्राम हैज बीन चार्टर्ड दिस वीक, इट पेन्स मी बिकॉज दिस इज द मंथ ऑफ व्हेन वी आर ऑल पेन्ड कश्मीरीज बिकॉज वी हैड टू लीव आवर होम्स एंड हर्थ्स which had been, which we had inherited from our ancestors. The subject is Kashmiri Pandit genocide, blot on secularism and democracy. I belong to the particular category, although I've been the government employee and retired in 2017. Let me come clear. So I will be focusing on the democracy and the secularism, how it played and how we became the victims. We became the victims of democracy when majority ruled. That kept us languishing as dispersed and scattered in our own country, which champions itself as the largest democratic system of governance with equal rights, irrespective of creed, caste, religion. We are passing through fourth decade of displacement, still not finding any ray of light in the long dark tunnel, when we shall go back to our homeland. Let me remind you, the history of J&K is somewhat peculiar. We welcomed wholeheartedly and supported when erstwhile princely state of Jammu and Kashmir, when it acceded to India as a free democratic country with secular credentials. We supported all nationalist political powers who shared power to strengthen democratic roots in J&K, not cosmetically, but with our emotions, and had deep abiding faith in Indian constitution. That was a ray of hope for this minuscule community to live peacefully in our motherland, not for material gains, but love of our ancestral land with our cultural linkage, which go thousands of years back. What we faced thereafter? Forced exodus from our homeland, being its indigenous population, having history of 5,000 years, which we lost in just in a certain few days, and became unwanted community, though immense sacrifice have been given for mutual coexistence, respect, tolerance, nurturing pluralistic society for development and progress of the state as well as the nations. The minuscule population of Kashmiri Hindus is hardly 4 to 5%. It could not be tolerated by a majority, suspecting them as informants of security forces, infidels, not supporting the cause of independence and their terrorist methods to achieve their goal at the behest of separatists, fundamentalists, and acting as proxies of terror modules who are being dictated from across the borders, and they became the new avatars. They were provided with latest arms, just like as if war was to be initiated, to wage war against the nation, to target killings who are hindrance to their scheme of things. Our democracy churches, human rights, secularism, where is now? Where it was then? There is no compunction by majority community, but they were glorifying that new romanticism of jihad in those days. I fully support Mr. Sumit, who just gave there was total uneasiness in Central Asia, and that it was as USSR had disintegrated, and it had its implication. And beside that, Operation Topak was put into action by our hostile neighbors. It impacted our lives, and one could not escape its pangs. The community lost compactness, culture, language, got scattered all across the country and other countries for survival. We are still fighting to claim our motherland in our own country. What a pity. But we all are still resilient. We will get it, but it may take some time, but it will be through peaceful means and under the law of the land. Where is this democracy taking us, our forsaken community? In addressing our resettlement with dignity and honor, which suffered ethnic cleansing and genocide since last 32 years, before it gets further erased from indigenous community as we are. Indigenous community, history of this nation needs to salvage democracy that has been getting eroded. People will start losing confidence. There are many such communities in our nation. We never got our true two representatives elected in the state legislature as the constituencies have been drawn and engineered in a manner to ensure that no community members get elected who takes up our cause. Of course, we've got seats on the individual goodwill, but they had on the dictates of the party line which had supported them, relegating our concerns, our inherent problems, and where we stand today. The genuine aspirations of Kashmiri Hindus got suppressed, marginalized, finally hounded out. Had the Democracy and Secularism acted, it would have acted as a bulwark against forces of separation and communalists. Today, state of Jammu and Kashmir would have not split it into two UTs. That is the outcome. That is the outcome. Before it gets further erased, this indigenous community from history, it needs to be to salvage democracy, which is getting eroded, and people started losing confidence. We never got as I told you, our leaders elected because these constituents were in such a manner managed that so that the actual representative could not just stand up for our cause. Had the Democracy and Secularism acted, it would have acted as a bulwark. It would have definitely stood against it so that the exodus of this minuscule peaceful community could not take place. And what is the outcome after 32 years? The state got split into two big UTs. There is no state now. In democracy, number is valued basically, as our community has no vote power, which can imbalance power center. This type of democracy and secularism is a mere sham, a blot for us. When our nation is celebrating 75 years of independence, we are still fighting for our rightful due, living refugees in our own country. The democracy needs to be modified, where due protection of minuscule minority rights are not trampled by majority to further their agenda against the separate of nation, so calling itself a champions of equality and protectors of all. I last of all conclude my point of view that immediately the government should chart out, because we have been had large expectation from the present dispensation that the resettlement will start and the community. I would suggest initially the community needs to settle at one particular place so that till they get full confidence to live as the government is proposing. But initially they should be taken back at a particular one particular place, which will sustain them, will having all those city-like type of facilities there. Number two, we should have nominated certain members elected in the state level whenever the election is held, because we will not be able, because the present system, which whatever is before us, I don't feel any such community member can get elected. Till then, we need a nomination for preservation of our culture, our ethnicity, so that our voice is heard and our concerns are addressed in the legislature. Number third, we are in a majority Muslim state. We need certain protection as a minority status should be given to us. We have not been totally deprived of our homeland. We have been deprived of our property. We have been deprived of our those jobs. We have been deprived of the land compensation, which was taken soon after reforms were taken place. We have been marginalized in all sections of this society, so that minority this act can take care of our survival, and so that the Pujani, which has already language outside, they can just find some solace to come back their own country, and they can claim that they are the sons of this soil. That is my demand. The way for going back to our homeland, which is a perpetual problem, and it will haunt us. It will haunt for centuries and the coming generation also, because how they can claim that Kashmir is our motherland. Thank you, Jai Hind.
Thank you, RGP Saab. Very important viewpoints, and especially now, all of us, all the speakers are coming out here with some of the demands which we would like to put forward. And this is one important common thing which is coming out, wherein how do we politically get involved? Because purposely, Kashmiri Pandits have been kept away from the political mainstream. And here is now the possibility that our own Kashmiri Pandits, political leaders get elected into the mainstream politics, as well as another thing which is very important is that other political parties should also support this Kashmiri Pandits genocide. I think going forward, we'll be raising further questions. And thanks a lot, IGP Saab. And now I move to someone, again, whom I admire a lot. A man with a mission to serve Bharat Mata. A man in action all the time. Ex-Director General of Police of UP, Vikram Singh Saab, 1974 batch. And, you know, Uttar Pradesh is in any case 25 times Australia, having 190,000 police force, known as the most decorated police officers in the country. He has been involved in national, international terrorist outfits like Al-Qaeda, Harkat-e-Ansar, Jaish-e-Mohammed, left-wing terrorism. He directly got involved for modernization and election of state-of-art technology and various universal best practices to make police effective. Many awards to him. He has got the President Police Medal 1987, 1988, 1989, 1990, President's Police Medal for long service, 96 President Medal, Katun Seva Medal 2001, and many more. He was on my new DNA of Leadership show. And I remember, and I want to share here with the audience, to the panelists, he certainly said on my program that we as Indians are really apologetic. It's a shame on the country. We are really apologetic to the Kashmiri Pandit community for this ethnic cleansing. This was what Director General of Police Vikram Singh Saab said on my new DNA of Leadership program. And he is not the only one. There are three army generals who came on a program, General Khurana, General G.D. Bakshi, and General A.K. Singh. Even they had a similar feeling that we would like to apologize to the community that we as Indians somehow missed to support Kashmiri Pandit genocide and Kashmiri Pandit exodus. And in fact, I would like to add, Pallavi Joshi, who is the producer, builder of Kashmir Files, she came on my Women Power show and she said, I apologize. She said like that, I apologize to the entire Kashmiri Pandit community ki hame sharam aati hai ek Hindustani ke naate, ye word istemal ki, Hindustani ke naate ki humne is Kashmiri Pandit ka itna genocide hua aur hame pata tak nahi chala. And today she has built up a very powerful movie. Having said that, I would request Vikram Singh Saab, he is my guru, on leadership, I respect him a lot. Vikram Singh Saab, all floor is yours. You have 7 minutes, aram se, make your viewpoint. You heard three direct victims, and we have discussed that entire country can become victim. That's what Ashwini ji said, that's what Peer Saab said, that's what's happening. And we are actually a face to them. Bachav apne desh ko. Apni izzat bachav. This is the time. Kashmiri Pandit to saamne hai. Zakhmi hai. Aap bachav. To aapne in tino ka sun liya. Aap roz debate karte hai. Over to you, sir.
Thank you very much, Mr. D.K. Bakshi, sir. It is a privilege and honor for me to share this wonderful platform with such eloquent and learned speakers like Ashwini ji, Sumit Peer ji, and Yogendra Kaul Sahab, and of course, you as well. I don't know what to say. My heart is bleeding. And in fact, it's very seldom that I'm without words. And today is the day after listening to the deep sense of pain and anguish of the esteemed speakers. I firstly would like to say, as people said, कायरता का ये न खेल हुआ होता, गद्दी पे सरदार पटेल हुआ होता, उग्रवाद की उम्र सांझ कर दी जाती, आतंकवादियों की गोद बांझ कर दी जाती. We are not supine, we are not tamasic. As they say in the फौज, मैं बिल्कुल लीगल बात करूंगा, इसलिए घबराइए मत. मेरा पहला धर्म है to cut the head of the cobra. क्योंकि कोबरा जिंदा रहेगा तो मैं जिंदा नहीं रहूंगा. हर समाज में बख्शी साहब, भेड़ और बकरी की बलि देने का प्राविधान है, शेर और चीते की बलि नहीं दी जाती. We went horribly wrong in 1990 and the murder of Tika Lal Tapluji and Justice Ganju were fault indicators that things are getting to be going from bad to worse. We did not wake up because of a complicit and an impotent system. My words may be harsh, lekin the definition of cowardice is when you're supposed to act and speak and you choose to look the other way. This is the highest form of cowardice. And if this is not cowardice, then what is? But now, happily, we have people like Ashwini ji. We have people like Manoj Sinha ji, our Honorable Home Minister and the Prime Minister. Even today, we can register cases. IG called Savitri, we can register cases against all those, the perpetrators. Respected Ashwini ji mentioned that the Nuremberg trials, the dignity of every single person, the dignity of the life and liberty and honor of every single person is non-negotiable. And here we compromised 219 murders in a span of a couple of years. Ethnic cleansing, and we pride ourselves as a secular democracy. It's the crying shame and a blot on us, on each one of us Indians who were mute spectators. There are laws in this country. The laws cannot be selective. Show me the man and I'll show you the rules. This business of ethnic cleansing, nobody has taken leave. But I would say, I blame the then Prime Minister V.P. Singh. I blame the then Home Minister Mufti Muhammad Saeed. And every person who is a part of the administration has a lot of answering to do. I would strongly recommend that cases be registered against each and every person who was in office and who had a duty to perform and failed the Kashmiri Pandits and Kashmir and India as a whole. We cannot look the other way. The time has come to atone for our sins and do prashchit. Because today, Ashwini ji, pura desh aapko kaatar drishti dekh raha hai, hamare Kashmiri Panditon ko aap le ja ke basaye, unko suraksha dein. Mehbooba ji ko pasand nahi aayega ye. Aisi lokpriyata pe lanat hai. मुझे ऐसी लोकप्रियता नहीं चाहिए, देश को ऐसी लोकप्रियता सस्ती नहीं चाहिए. आज आप युग पुरुष हैं, परमात्मा ने आपको सामर्थ्य दिया है कि कश्मीरी पंडितों के साथ जो अन्याय हुआ है उस पर कुछ योगदान, उनके मान सम्मान का, उनके पुनर्वास का आप कर सकें. ये बहुत ही क्रांतिकारी क्षण है. इसमें मेरा परामर्श होगा कि इसमें चूके ना, इसमें वो कार्रवाई कर दें जो जनता बड़ी कातर दृष्टि से आपको देख रही है. मुझे पूरी उम्मीद है कि जो व्यवस्था आपने की है, और आप ऐसे ओजस्वी राजनेता जहां होंगे, आप डी के बख्शी साहब की बातें, जी के पीडी की बातें, यू विल गो एंड टेक देम एट द प्रॉपर कोर्स एंड एनश्योर दैट दे आर एड्रेस्ड अप्रोप्रिएटली. यू सर वेरी राइटली मेंशन द न्यूरेमबर्ग ट्रायल्स. देयर इज नॉट अ पैरेलल इन ह्यूमन हिस्ट्री अदर देन द एक्सटर्मिनेशन ऑफ ज्यूज बाय एडोल्फ हिटलर एंड द नाजीज एंड द एक्सटर्मिनेशन एंड genocide of Kashmiri Pandits. I would treat them at the same pedestal. And therefore, the severity of punishment should also be the same. It cannot be go unnoticed or by default. And to do so would be committing an even bigger sin, because then I would again be playing politics and being party and privy to those who are the villains of the whole story. D.K. Bakshi Saab, esteemed panelists, उस जमाने में एक कविता कही गई थी किसी ने, मुझे आज भी मुझे झंझोर देती है मेरी अंतरात्मा को. यही JKNLF वाले टेररिस्ट, दे यूज टू कम टू यूपी एंड दे वर गिविंग अ बिफिटिंग रिसेप्शन. दे ऑल वेंट इनटू पास्ट टेंस. इफ दे ऑल कुड गो इनटू पास्ट टेंस इन उत्तर प्रदेश एंड दिल्ली, व्हाई कुड दे नॉट गो इनटू पास्ट टेंस इन कश्मीर ऑल्सो. कहीं ना कहीं मुझे दिखाई पड़ रहा है कि यू वर नॉट सीरियस अबाउट व्हाट यू वाज एक्सपेक्टेड एंड सपोज्ड टू डू. जब धरती के दामन पर हो दाग लहू के होली के, कैसे मैं गीत सुना दूं बिंदिया कुमकुम रोली के। जो पूजा के फूल सरे आम बेच दे बाजारों में, मैं ऐसे ठेकेदारों का नाम बताने आया हूं, घायल भारत माता की तस्वीर दिखाने आया। डीके बख्शी साहब, माई हार्ट इज क्राइंग एंड बिफोर आई ब्रेक डाउन बिफोर यू, यू प्लीज फॉरगिव मी, आई विश यू ऑल द बेस्ट एंड विद द डीपेस्ट सेंस ऑफ ग्रेटिट्यूड, थैंक यू वेरी मच।
Vikram Singh Saab, knowing you and personally, you know, you are my mentor, and the way you come across and highly emotional on such issues, and especially for our community issues, I'm really grateful for sparing time. And please stay back. I know you have another program. I will have one or two questions before you leave. And you are absolutely right. बड़े ज़माने के ठेकेदार रहे हैं कश्मीरी पंडितों के। The friendship between Sheikh Abdullah and Jawaharlal Nehru, the friendship between Rajiv Gandhi and Farooq Abdullah, everybody knows about it. और आज पटेल साहब को हम याद करते हैं, अगर वो जमाना होता कि पटेल साहब सामने होते और ये नेहरू का जमाना नहीं आया होता तो देश की दशा ही कुछ और होती। We are unfortunate that Nehru played a game plan and got I will not say Gandhi also, but Nehru was our prime minister, while as Patel would have been our prime minister, and things in the country would have been different. Unfortunately, ye thekedar Sheikh Abdullah and Nehru and another Farooq Abdullah एंड राजीव गांधी, ये हिस्ट्री बताती है, पूरा उसी टाइम की ये सारी चीजें हुई है। और आज कश्मीरी पंडित जेनोसाइड इज ओनली बिकॉज ऑफ दिस अब्दुल्ला फैमिली एंड दिस मुफ्ती फैमिली। आई कीप टॉकिंग अबाउट दिस मुफ्तीज एंड अब्दुल्लाज, यू विल सी दैट कश्मीरी पंडित्स विल वन डे गो बैक टू बैक टू आवर ओन रूट्स कश्मीर वैली। Unfortunately, today we have Taliban Khan, Imran Khan, as the Prime Minister of Pakistan, who, being a sportsman, destroyed Pakistan and is only thinking about Kashmir. Sad state of affairs. Anyhow, let me now, Vikram Saab, thank you so much. Let me go back to someone, but she is sick and she is running 102 temperature, but she said she will come here. She is a top level social activist. Subuhi Khan from Meerut. Agar unka background dekhenge, itna top class background, and she fights every day. She is a Supreme Court lawyer. She has been fighting against Citizenship Amendment Act 2019. She has been fighting when there was triple talaq issues, and she has been supporting that. She is a real brand ambassador of Jai Hind and Bharat Mata Ki Jai. क्योंकि यहां पे हिंदुस्तान में भारत माता की जय बोले, जय हिंद बोले, वो पॉसिबल नहीं है। थाईलैंड में मैं बोलता हूं, पर हिंदुस्तान में अगर मैं जाऊंगा कश्मीर यूनिवर्सिटी में, आई कैन नॉट से आई वेंट टू जम्मू यूनिवर्सिटी, आई सेड भारत माता की जय, वंदे मातरम, हवल की लड़की बोलेगी। एंड नईम अख्तर साहब बैठे थे स्टेज पे, ही वॉज दैट टाइम एजुकेशन मिनिस्टर, एंड पी आर सेठी जी बैठी हुई थी स्टेज पे। आई वॉज डूइंग दिस प्रोग्राम विद प्रोफेसर एम आई सेंट्रल यूनिवर्सिटी, and I said, yeah, Haval ki ladki jo aayi hai, Bharat Mata ki jai bole. And Naeem Akhtar sahab, after Raj Nehru bhi baithe the hamare saath. Aur jab program khatam hua, Naeem Akhtar sahab mere paas bagal mein aaye, kehte bada junoon hai Kashmiri pandit aapko. Maine kaha junoon hi hamesha rahega. Ye Naeem hi tha shayad. I said, he was the minister that time. It's just that, I think 2017 or 2018 ki baat. With that, I am getting someone who is really passionate, who has been fighting for our cause. And she has been speaking at various forums about this. She was part of a Women Power program, and I really admire this youngest star of my country. Subhuji ji, mujhe pata hai, aapka 102 bukhar hai. Aur uske baad bhi aap aaye. Main aapko call kara tha, aapne kaha main already baithi hu, ab aaye. Let's give a big round of applause to Subhuji ji. Subhuji ji, aap apna point of view, chahe 5 minute rakhna chahte hai, 7 minute rakhna, aap pe nirbhar karta hai.
थैंक यू सो मच बख्शी साहब। मेरी आवाज आज शायद स्ट्रेंथ में कम रहेगी, लेकिन मेरे शब्द हमेशा वही रहेंगे जो भारत माता के लिए रहते हैं। थैंक यू सो मच, थैंक यू सो मच। सबसे पहले तो मैं ये कहना चाहती हूँ कि जब बहुत शरीर टूट रहा था, एक बार मन ये किया कि शायद अपोलोजाइज कर दूं बख्शी जी को कि बहुत ज्यादा तबीयत खराब है, लेकिन फिर अचानक से बैठे बैठे ख्याल आया कि मैं इतनी तकलीफ में तो नहीं हूँ जितनी तकलीफ में हमारे कश्मीरी हिंदू भाई बहन रहे होंगे। तो हम लोग कहीं ना कहीं अपने कंफर्ट लेवल से भी हमें निकलना पड़ेगा, बुखार या अपना डेली कोर्स या हमारी नौकरियां या हमारी जिम्मेदारियां, वो सब तो चलती रहेंगी, लेकिन अगर हम भारत में पैदा हुए हैं, हम भारत को माता कहते हैं, तो हमारे देश में कहीं भी अगर हमारे भाई बहन के साथ कोई इतना बड़ा अत्याचार हो और उसमें हम आराम से अपने घर के कंफर्ट लेवल में बैठ जाएं, तो कहीं ना कहीं उस अपराध को मौन समर्थन हम भी दे रहे हैं। मेरी बातें बहुत सारे लोगों को कड़वी लग सकती हैं, लेकिन मैं बख्शी जी आज दो बातों पे बात करना चाहूंगी। यहाँ पे सब एस्टीम्ड पैनलिस्ट बैठे हैं और सब लोगों ने उदाहरण भी दिए वहां पर क्या हुआ, सब जानते हैं बिकॉज सालों से हम लोग बात करते आ रहे हैं, लेकिन मैं दो कॉन्सेप्ट आज क्लियर करना चाहूंगी, दो नरेटिव। देखिए, आजाद भारत का सबसे बड़ा जेनोसाइड, भारत के इतिहास में इतना बड़ा मास रेप मर्डर स्लॉटर शायद ही कभी हुआ हो। हाँ, 1947 में हुआ था, तभी भी इस्लामिक स्टेट बनाने के लिए भारत को तोड़ा गया, इतना मिलियंस एंड मिलियंस ऑफ भारतीय डिस्प्लेस हुए, उनका रेप्स हुए, मर्डर्स हुए, जेनोसाइड हुआ। कहीं ना कहीं हम लोग फिर भी संभल गए क्योंकि हम लोग के अंदर एक कहते हैं ना कि एक धर्म निरपेक्ष फीलिंग है, हम लोग कई बार माफ करने में बिलीव करते हैं, हम लोग कहीं ना कहीं कार्मिक लॉ में बिलीव करते हैं कि हाँ जो कर्म करेगा वो सहेगा। तो उस कारण भी शायद हम लोगों ने दोबारा से अपने देश को एक पीसफुल बना लिया, लेकिन आज हम जो स्थिति देख रहे हैं बख्शी जी, वो ये देख रहे हैं कि द्विराष्ट्रवाद या जो इस्लामिक स्टेट बनाने की जो थ्योरी थी वो 1947 में खत्म नहीं हुई है। हम लोगों को लगा कि हाँ वहां खत्म हो गई, इस्लामिक स्टेट बन गया, अब हम आराम से सेक्युलर इंडिया में रहेंगे, ऐसा नहीं है। द्विराष्ट्रवाद की मानसिकता भारत में आज भी चल रही है, और देखिए रातों रात तो बन नहीं जाता इस्लामिक स्टेट। इस्लामिक स्टेट बनाने के लिए एक माहौल बनाना पड़ता है, पहले मुसलमान बच्चे को दिमाग में अलगाववाद के बीज डाले जाते हैं कि तुम भारत से अलग हो, तुम्हारा पहनना ओढ़ना, तुम्हारा खाना पीना, तुम्हारा लाइफस्टाइल, तुम अजीब अजीब फतवा ब्रिगेड है, फतवे दिए जाते हैं, मुसलमान बच्चा बिंदी नहीं लगा सकता, मुसलमान लड़की बाल नहीं खोल सकती, मुसलमान कुछ नहीं कर सकता जो भारतवासी कर रहे हैं। जब वो एक अलगाववादी बन जाता है तब सेकेंड स्टेज होती है उसको कट्टरवादी बनाने की, यानी कि जो आप सोच रहे हैं वही सही है बाकी सब गलत है। जब ये कट्टरवादी वाली स्टेज भी क्रॉस हो जाती है तब लास्ट स्टेज होती है आतंकवादी बनाने की। इस स्टेज में आके ये आतंकवादी, ये भारत विरोधी, ये विधर्मी इस्लामिक स्टेट की मांग करते हैं। इस स्टेट पर आके मास रेप मर्डर स्लॉटर्स होते हैं, इस स्टेट पर आके ये लोग खुलकर सामने आते हैं, और हम देख रहे हैं कि कश्मीर में ये हुआ। जब ये लोग नारे लगाते हैं हमें चाहिए आजादी, हमें चाहिए आजादी, तो इनसे ये पूछा जाए किससे, भारत से? अगर इनको भारत से वाकई आजादी चाहिए तो 50 से ज्यादा इस्लामिक स्टेट्स हैं, वहां क्यों नहीं जाते हैं? एक्चुअली इनको भारत से आजादी नहीं चाहिए, एक्चुअली भारत विरोधी मानसिकताओं को इस्लाम के नाम पे अलगाववाद, कट्टरवाद और आतंकवाद का एक नरेटिव क्रिएट करके भारत को तोड़ना है। ये सिर्फ और सिर्फ भारत को टुकड़ों में बांटने वाली जो थ्योरी है वो चल रही है। और देखिए, जब हम कहते हैं कि कश्मीरी हिंदुओं के साथ ये हुआ, 30 साल पहले तकरीबन कश्मीरी भाई बहनों के साथ ये हुआ, अभी कुछ महीने पहले बंगाल में भाई बहनों के साथ ये हुआ, उत्तर प्रदेश में कैराना नाम की जगह है वहां पे हमारे भाई बहनों के साथ ये हुआ, हरियाणा में मेवात जैसी एक जगह है वहां पर हो रहा है। जब हम सेक्युलरिज्म के नाम पे माइनॉरिटिज्म का नंगा नाच खेलते हैं और माइनॉरिटीज के साथ खून भी माफ करते हैं, तब हम ये क्यों नहीं सोचते कि कितनी स्टेट्स ऐसी हैं, कितने शहर ऐसे हैं जहां पे हिंदूज एक्चुअली माइनॉरिटी बन गए। हिंदूज को बहुत जगह माइनॉरिटी बना दिया गया है, विस्थापन बहुत जगह हो रहा है। अभी तकरीबन 15,000-20,000 तो बंगाल वायलेंस के बाद आई थिंक असम में जाकर लोग कैंप्स में रहे हैं। तो देखिए, हमें ये समझना पड़ेगा कि जो हमारे कश्मीरी हिंदू भाई बहन निकाले गए कश्मीर से, उनको वापस सम्मान के साथ, इज्जत के साथ, डिग्निटी के साथ वहां पहुंचाया तो जाए, लेकिन आगे किसी भी हिंदू भाई बहन के साथ ऐसा ना हो, उसकी तरफ हमें काम करना पड़ेगा। उसकी तरफ हमें काम करने के लिए द्विराष्ट्रवाद की थ्योरी खत्म करनी पड़ेगी। जो भारत में रहता है चाहे वो किसी भी संप्रदाय का हो, उसको भारत की प्रिंसिपल्स, भारत की नेशनल एथॉस, भारत की वैल्यूज, भारत के कायदे कानून मानने पड़ेंगे। भारत में रह के जब आप हर चीज, आप अलग कानून मांगते हैं, आप अलग जुडिशरी मांगते हैं, आप हर चीज, आपका पूरी एक अलग हलाल इकोनॉमी के नाम पे एक पूरी इकोनॉमी चल रही है। कहते हैं कि नॉनवेज को हराम हलाल बोला जाता था, कि भाई एक जानवर को काटने का कोई एक प्रोसेस है, वो इस कारण उसको हलाल बोला जाता है कि उसमें से उसके शरीर से खून निकल जाता है। लेकिन आज आप देखिए, हलाल नमक है मार्केट में, हलाल आटा है मार्केट में, हलाल झाड़ू है मार्केट में, ये क्या है? ये एक ही कंट्री में एक पैरेलल इकोनॉमी खड़ी करी जा रही है। अलगाववादी, कट्टरवादी, आतंकवादी, हलाल इकोनॉमी, अलग अलग संगठन है। कोई अलगाववादी बना रहा है, कोई कट्टरवादी बना रहा है, कोई आतंकवादी बना रहा है, देन पैसों की जरूरत पड़ती है तो PFI जैसे संगठन है। एक उदाहरण मैं आपको देती हूँ, यूरोप में कुछ आतंकवादी पकड़े गए, जब उनकी जांच, अलकायदा के टेररिस्ट पकड़े गए, जब उनकी जांच हुई तो पता चला कि उनकी रिक्रूटमेंट तबलीगी जमात से हुई थी। तो देखिए, तबलीगी जमात पर से कोई टेरर आउटफिट नहीं है, लेकिन कट्टरवादी संगठन है। तो एक आतंकवादी संगठनों के लिए रिक्रूटमेंट करने के लिए कट्टरवादी संगठन एक फ्रूटफुल ग्राउंड है। तो अगर हमें आतंकवाद को खत्म करना है तो हमें अलगाववाद को भी खत्म करना पड़ेगा, हमें इस तरह के सभी संगठनों को कर्ब करना पड़ेगा, काबू में करना पड़ेगा, कंट्रोल करना पड़ेगा, जो कहीं ना कहीं द्विराष्ट्रवाद की ये थ्योरी हमारे देश में चलाते हैं। ये बातें तो मैंने कही भारत के मुसलमानों की आंखें खोलने के लिए। एक बात अब जो मैं बोलने जा रही हूँ वो सभी भारतवासियों की आंखें खोलने के लिए। मेरे गुरुजी से मुझे ये सूत्र मिला है। मेरे गुरुजी ने बताया कि 1857 की जब क्रांति हुई तो उससे पहले तकरीबन 25 साल संतों ने पूरे देश में घूम घूम के जागरण किया। उन्होंने हर हिंदू को ये बताया कि इतने सालों से तुम्हारे साथ क्या होता आ रहा है। तो भाषा, जाति, क्षेत्र, संप्रदाय सब भूल के हर भारतवासी भारत के लिए खड़ा हुआ। तब 1857 की क्रांति हुई और हम सब जानते हैं कि उसमें क्या हुआ, अंग्रेजों के दांत खट्टे हुए। उसके बाद उन लोगों ने प्रॉपर रिसर्च करी, उन्होंने भारत का पूरा भू मनोविज्ञान समझा और वो ये समझ गए कि भारत का भू मनोविज्ञान चार कारक प्रभावित करते हैं, भाषा, जाति, क्षेत्र और संप्रदाय। जब ये चार कारक एक होते हैं, संगठित होते हैं, तो भारत विश्वगुरु है। और जब ये चार कारक आपस में लड़ रहे हैं या बटे हुए हैं तो ये अलगाववाद और विभाजन का कारण बनते हैं। तो कहीं ना कहीं हमें उस भाषा, जाति, क्षेत्र और संप्रदाय की मानसिकता से ऊपर उठ के भारत को भारत की नजर से देखना पड़ेगा। बख्शी जी, क्षेत्र का मैं एक एग्जाम्पल दे देती हूँ। बंगाल में हिंदू के साथ क्या हो रहा है हम सब जानते हैं, फांसी पर चढ़ाए जा रहे हैं, कैसी कैसी ग्राफिक पिक्चर्स, वीडियोस मेरे पास आती हैं। लेकिन दिल्ली में लोग शांत बैठे रहते हैं कि बंगाल में हो रहा है, हम तो सुरक्षित हैं। दिल्ली को CNRC में आग में झोंक दिया जाता है, देश की राजधानी को, फॉरेन फंडिंग हो जाती है, धू धू करके जल रहा था देश की राजधानी दिल्ली। लेकिन उत्तर प्रदेश में लोग शांत थे कि भाई तो दिल्ली में हो रहा है, हम तो सेफ है। उत्तर प्रदेश को जाति के नाम पे बांट दिया जाता है। उत्तर प्रदेश में जैसे मैंने आपको कैराने का उदाहरण दिया, वहां पे हिंदुओं का विस्थापन हुआ, लेकिन केरल में लोग शांत रहेंगे कि हमारे ऊपर क्या फर्क पड़ता है, केरल को वामपंथी बिल्कुल नाश कर जाएंगे, कश्मीर को क्या फर्क पड़ता है। कश्मीरी हिंदुओं का मास रेप मर्डर स्लॉटर हो गया, लेकिन केवल ग्लोबल कश्मीरी पंडित डायस्पोरा ही उनके बारे में बात क्यों कर रहे हैं, केवल कश्मीरी हिंदू ही उनके बारे में बात क्यों कर रहे हैं। मैं सुबूही खान उसके बारे में बात क्यों ना करूं, और मैं सड़कों पे क्यों ना उतरे, हम हमारे भाई बहनों के साथ अगर ये हो, आपके साथ ही बख्शी जी हम गुड़गांव में वो एक कश्मीरी हिंदू जो एक महिला थी उनके रेस्टोरों में गए थे, उन्होंने कैसी एक कहानी बताई थी कि मतलब दिल रो दिया था। माता माल रेस्टोरों दिल रो दिया था वो सुनकर कि जब वो उनका करोड़ों की प्रॉपर्टी रातों रात उनको पीनट्स के भाव बेचकर वहां से जाना पड़ा, और इतने अच्छे संपन्न परिवार के वो लोग और किराए के मकान में उनको रहना पड़ा। और सिर्फ यही उनका टॉर्चर खत्म नहीं हुआ, वो बता रही थी कि जब आई थिंक 25-30 साल के बाद वो वहां गई अभी रिसेंटली, तो वहां पे कोई मुस्लिम परिवार रहता है और जो उनका मंदिर था उस घर में वहां पे उन्होंने टॉयलेट बनाया हुआ है। क्या हम उस दर्द को इमेजिन कर सकते हैं, ये मतलब किस तरह वो लोग सोते होंगे। वो तो कहीं आतंकवादी नहीं बने, हम कई बार ये नरेटिव क्रिएट किया जाता है कि हाँ भाई मुसलमान बच्चे आतंकवादी बन रहे हैं। कश्मीरी हिंदुओं से ज्यादा मास रेप मर्डर स्लॉटर किसी के साथ हुआ है, या हिंदुओं से ज्यादा एथनिक क्लेंजिंग किसी के साथ हुई है? लेकिन हिंदू तो कभी आतंकवादी नहीं बना, हिंदू तो अपनी मेहनत से ही कहीं रेस्टोरेंट खोल रहा है, कहीं कोई छोटे लघु कुटीर उद्योग बना रहा है और एक इज्जत और सम्मान के साथ अपना जीवन काट रहा है। तो मुझे लगता है कि कमी हमसे सिर्फ यहाँ होती है बख्शी जी, कि हम भाषा जाति क्षेत्र संप्रदाय से ऊपर उठकर भारत को भारत की दृष्टि से देखते हुए बोले। अगर देश में कहीं भी किसी भाई बहन के साथ खराब हो रहा है तो हम अपना कम्फर्ट लेवल छोड़कर, अपनी डेली रूटीन छोड़कर उनके साथ कंधे से कंधा मिलाकर खड़े हो, फिजिकली नहीं खड़े हो सकते हैं तो ऑनलाइन खड़े हुई है। आजकल तो ये सोशल मीडिया हमारा एक बहुत महत्वपूर्ण शस्त्र है। जिस भी तरह से हूँ हम एक दूसरे के साथ खड़े हूँ। इसी बात से अपनी वाणी को विराम देती हूँ और कुछ लोगों को ये भी बताना चाहती हूँ जो बहुत लोग नहीं जानते होंगे कि विक्रम सिंह जी मेरे बुजुर्ग हैं, मेरे लिए पिता समान है, बहुत ज्यादा मैं उनको सम्मान देती हूँ। और जहां भी कभी अपने अभियान में जहां भी कभी अटकती हूँ, किसी एडवाइस की गाइडेंस की जरूरत पड़ती है तो उनको अप्रोच करती हूँ, तो हमेशा अच्छी सलाह मिलती है। कभी भी कोई छोटा सा कोई अचीवमेंट होता है तो उनको भेजती हूँ, तो एक पिता की तरह वो मुझे कॉन्ग्रेचुलेट करते हैं। तो देखिए ये है हमारा भारत, यहाँ पर किसी को प्यार या नफरत संप्रदाय के आधार पर नहीं की जाती है, यहाँ पर प्यार या नफरत कर्म के आधार पर की जाती है। इसी बात से अपनी वाणी को विराम देती हूँ। जय हिंद, वंदे मातरम।
वंदे मातरम सुबुई जी, एंड आपकी वाणी सुंदर, सब कुछ सुंदर। सच बोलने से वाणी में बल आता है, मीठा बोलने से वाणी में यश आता है, और आपकी वाणी हमेशा यश बोले। और हम आई पर्सनली फील प्राउड ऑफ यू, वी हैव हैड कपल ऑफ इंटरेक्शंस एंड आई
थैंक यू सो मच।
यू आर एन एम्बेसडर ऑफ आवर कंट्री। यू आर ब्रिंगिंग इन the concept, what is going on, today gang against, जब आप बोलते हो तो मजा आता है। और आज आपने हमारे ग्लोबल कश्मीरी पंडित डायस्पोरा में आके आपने हमारे साथ मिलके इस मिशन को आगे बढ़ाने के लिए जो आपने विचार दिए, आई एम रियली ग्रेटफुल टू यू, इरिस्पेक्टिव ऑफ ऑल ऑड्स विद यू टुडे, एंड वी स्पोक एट 6:30 एंड आई वाज नॉट श्योर बट यू केम। आई सैल्यूट यू एंड आई रिस्पेक्ट यू सुबोई जी, and very powerful thoughts.
Now, thank you so much, Bakshi ji, can I speak for one more minute?
Yeah, please.
मैं एक बहुत महत्वपूर्ण बात बोलना भूल गई थी, मुझे लगता है कि मुझे ये भी बताना चाहिए। बहुत important एक दृष्टिकोण है, उस तरह से भी हमें देखना चाहिए कि जब हम भाषा जाति क्षेत्र संप्रदाय में बट जाते हैं तो कहीं ना कहीं हम कमजोर हो जाते हैं। और भारत को तोड़ने के लिए 7 भारत विरोधी मानसिकताएं एक्टिवली काम कर रही हैं। मैं उन 7 के नाम जरूर आपके चैनल के माध्यम से बोलना चाहूंगी। सबसे पहली भारत विरोधी मानसिकता है वामपंथी और उनकी आर्म्ड विंग्स माओवादी और नक्सलवादी। छद्म नारीवादी या सूडो फेमिनिस्ट भी भारत को तोड़ना चाहते हैं, वो जो ब्लड स्टेन्ड सैनिटरी पैड लेके सबरीमाला पहुंच जाती हैं फीमेल एक्टिविस्ट्स, वो सब सूडो फेमिनिस्ट वामपंथियों की ही एक विंग है। देन दूसरी भारत विरोधी मानसिकता है अलगाववादी कट्टरवादी और आतंकवादी संगठन, वो प्राइमरीली 2 चल रहे हैं। एक इस्लाम संप्रदाय के लोगों को अलगाववादी कट्टरवादी आतंकवादी बना के इस्लामिक स्टेट बनाने के लिए प्रेरित कर रहे हैं, एक खालसा पंथ के बच्चों को अलगाववादी कट्टरवादी और आतंकवादी बना के खालिस्तान बनाने के लिए प्रेरित कर रहे हैं। हम इस्लामिक स्टेट के खिलाफ हैं लेकिन इस्लाम के नहीं, हम खालिस्तान के खिलाफ हैं लेकिन खालसा पंथ के नहीं, क्योंकि भारत में कभी भी पंथ की लड़ाई रही ही नहीं। हिंदू इज अ कॉमनवेल्थ ऑफ ऑल मोड्स ऑफ वर्शिप। कश्मीर से लेके कन्याकुमारी तक हमारे देश में इतनी पूजा पद्धतियां हैं, इतने आराध्य हैं, इतनी उपासना पद्धतियां हैं, हम लोग कभी भी पूजा पद्धति के नाम पे लड़ने वाले लोग नहीं है। और पूरे विश्व में भारत ही एक ऐसा देश है जहां पे शायद ही इतनी मोड्स ऑफ वर्शिप सम्मान के साथ और सुरक्षा के साथ रहती है। तीसरी भारत विरोधी मानसिकता है बौद्धिक आतंकवादी, जो इंटेलेक्चुअल टेररिस्ट है, जो बहुत ही इंसीडियस वे में धीरे धीरे हमारे देश के बच्चों को भारत से तोड़ते हैं। ये लोग वेल स्पोकन है, वेल ड्रेस्ड है, यूनिवर्सिटीज में है, कॉलेजेस में है, ब्यूरोक्रेसी में है, हिस्टोरियंस हैं, मीडिया में है, फिल्म इंडस्ट्री में है, पॉलिटिक्स में है, और ये लोग इतना पॉलिश्ड होते हैं कि कई बार पढ़े लिखे बच्चे इनके कहने में आ जाते हैं। तो इन बौद्धिक आतंकवादियों से भी हमें बचने की जरूरत है। देन इंटरनेशनल पावर्स नेचुरली, जब CNRC में पैसा आ जाता है देश के खिलाफ भारत को जलाने के लिए, या फिर उत्तर प्रदेश में हाथरस प्रकरण में देखिए कितना पैसा आ गया था, वेबसाइट्स बन गई थी, तो ये सब इंटरनेशनल पावर्स बाहर से पैसा लगाती हैं। देन विधर्मी राजनीतिक दल हैं जो सत्ता में आने के लिए किसी भी पॉलिटिकल पार्टी के साथ हाथ मिला लेते हैं। देन कन्वर्जन माफिया, ये वो लोग हैं जो किसी आदिवासी बेल्ट में जाएंगे, किसी को एक हाथ से दो रोटी खिलाएंगे, दूसरे हाथ से उसके गले में क्रॉस डाल देंगे। देखिए वो परमेश्वर, वो परमात्मा, वो इतना तुच्छ, इतना छोटी मेंटालिटी का नहीं हो सकता कि किसी की भूख इस शर्त पे मिटता है कि पहले मुझे मानो तब मैं तुम्हारी भूख मिटाऊंगा। तो देखिए ये जो रिलीजन के नाम पे, पंथ के नाम पे, जो पंथ सत्ता चलाते हैं, जो स्टेट क्राफ्ट बना देते हैं रिलीजन को, उन लोगों के हम खिलाफ हैं। और इसको ना ही आप कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनली गलत कह सकते हैं, इसको ना ही आप यूनाइटेड नेशंस में गलत कह सकते हैं, बिकॉज ये बिल्कुल लॉजिकल बात है। हमारे संविधान में अगर फंडामेंटल राइट्स हैं तो फंडामेंटल ड्यूटीज भी हैं। देश की एकता और अखंडता के लिए हर भारतवासी को खड़ा होना हमारी फंडामेंटल ड्यूटी है। तो अगर हम किसी इस्लामिक स्टेट के खिलाफ या खालिस्तान के खिलाफ या कन्वर्जन माफिया के खिलाफ खड़े हैं तो हम इस्लाम या खालसा पंथ या क्रिश्चियनिटी के खिलाफ नहीं खड़े हैं, हम इन रिलीजन्स को मिसयूज करके हमारे देश को तोड़ने वालों के खिलाफ खड़े हैं। देन लास्ट बट नॉट द लीस्ट, सातवीं भारत विरोधी मानसिकता है कॉरपोरेट माफिया, बाजारवाद, जिनके लिए सब कुछ सिर्फ पैसा है, दवाइयां बेचने के लिए बड़ी बड़ी बीमारियां ईजाद होती हैं, अस्पताल चलने चाहिए, दवाइयां बिकनी चाहिए, कोई मरता है सो मरे। इन लोगों का भी सबसे बड़ा दुश्मन भारत है, क्योंकि भारत के मूल में ही प्रकृति से मैत्री है। अगर कोई मुझसे पूछता है कि हिंदू का एक कॉमन एक कोई ट्रेट बताइए, तो मैं कहती हूँ हिंदू मतलब प्रकृति का मित्र। आप किसी भी रिचुअल, किसी, अभी हमने मकर संक्रांति मनाई थी, देश में कितनी जगह अलग अलग नाम से मकर संक्रांति मनाई जाती है, लेकिन सूर्य की कोई एक पोजिशन होती है उसको हम सम्मान करते हैं, उसको हम पूजते हैं। तो हिंदू के लिए भगवान मतलब भूमि, भगवान भूमि, गगन, वायु, अग्नि, नीर। तो हिंदू की में तो इतनी बड़ी, इतनी विचार मानसिकता है, इतनी विशाल और सब लोगों को अपने अंदर समा लेने वाली समझस्ता है कि संप्रदाय की लड़ाई हमारे देश में कभी हो ही नहीं सकती। ये सिर्फ भारत को तोड़ने वाले लोग कर रहे हैं। और मैं बस यही कहना चाहती हूँ कि हम अपनी संस्कृति को सब लोग मिलजुल के समझें और हाथ एक दूसरे का हाथ से हाथ मिला के, कंधे से कंधा मिलाकर अपने भारत के भाई बहनों के लिए लड़ें। इसी बात से अपनी वाणी को दोबारा विराम देती हूँ। जय हिंद, वंदे मातरम।
जय हिंद, वंदे मातरम। सुबुई जी, बहुत अच्छे विचार आपके हैं, ये सात चीजें आपने शेयर कर दी है। फैक्ट है, देयर आर पॉलिटिकल प्रोस्टिट्यूट्स, देयर आर मीडिया प्रोस्टिट्यूट्स, वी ऑल सी दैट एवरी डे हैपनिंग ऑन टेलीविजन चैनल। नाउ लेट मी क्विकली मूव टू कपल ऑफ क्वेश्चंस, एंड आई वुड लाइक टू गो टू फर्स्ट टू यू नो डायरेक्टर जनरल ऑफ पुलिस विक्रम सिंह साहब। विक्रम सिंह साहब, नाउ यू हैव सीन, यू नो अबाउट एंटायर थिंग, how do you see Kashmiri Pandits, do you think they should really get into the political mileage, get into the politics and fight for their rights? Do you propose Kashmiri Pandits, political leaders, to be totally visible in the country and make an impact? Do you see this happening in days to come? Do you see our political leaders taking that positioning in the country? Because you are not a Kashmiri Pandit. That is the reason I am asking this question to you. Because hamari jo political leaders ko kaise aage badhna chahiye? And I am talking about community Kashmiri Pandit political leaders.
Mr. Bakshi, may I? Nothing is more powerful than an idea whose time has come. And the idea of giving respect and rehabilitation to Kashmiri Pandits has come now. Today is the time, and today is the time to pursue it so vigorously. As Sir Winston Churchill says, we shall fight on the beaches, we shall fight on land, we shall fight in the air. Let every Kashmiri Pandit and every Indian and every person, because this crime is not against just Kashmiri Pandits, it is a crime against humanity, where humanity is the complainant. Every person who feels strongly, let him make an issue out of it, that those people who will speak in favor of the rehabilitation of Kashmiri Pandits, and as Mr. Sumit ji had said, that market value of the property, and even more, because there can be no compensation for the horrible atrocities that they have gone through, because the memory files will always be permanent for them, and for many generations, they are not going away. Therefore, the least that the government can do is to compensate them at market value, rehabilitate them, even if it costs the world. And I can tell you, it is perfectly doable. The petty politicians will not decide where the Kashmiri Pandits will. The nation will decide, and the Kashmiri Pandits will decide where they are going to decide. Wherever they put their fingers on, that is the location where Kashmiri Pandits will be rehabilitated with dignity, honor, and the greatest of respect, and also an apology from a very grateful nation.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much. Main Chungu sahab aapke paas aana chahta hu, Now, what is that emotional grudge you have in mind as a Kashmiri Pandit, as a Kashmiri Pandit leader, and even as a BJP leader? That entire country slept, entire country did not bother about us. Do you still hold that political grudge so powerful in your heart? And how would you get relief from that emotional grudge you have that what happened to our community in 1990? And what seems to be your thinking to take steps forward to reduce that emotional grudge about that entire country slept, did not bother?
देखिए बख्शी साहब, एक चीज जो समय ने सिखा दिया है और वो ये है कि हर चीज के लिए समय होता है और विधवा विलाप का समय चला गया है. This is not the time for us now to wail and weep, but it is the time to get things done. समय आ गया है जब हमने जो हमने विचार किया है, जो हमने संकल्प लिए हैं, उनको चरितार्थ करने का समय आ गया है. This is the time for realization of the dreams. And when you are going for realization of your dreams, it is important not to be bogged down, not to be bogged down with the bad things of the past. ये बात सही है कि आप एक रेफरेंस टू द कॉन्टेक्स्ट हमेशा काम करते हैं, बात करते हैं, लेकिन रोना धोना जो है उसका समय चला गया. और मैं अपने सारे मित्रों से भी ये कहता रहता हूं कि ज्यादातर इन चीजों में समय ना बिताएं कि हम सिर्फ ये कहते रहें कि हमारे साथ क्या हुआ, बल्कि अब हमने ये सारी चीजें ठीक कैसे होंगी वो हमने करना है. इसके लिए ये विधवा विलाप, रोना धोना, वेलिंग एंड वीपिंग, ये चैप्टर छोड़ना पड़ेगा. इस चैप्टर से बाहर आकर के चीजों को दुरुस्त करने के लिए कार्य करना पड़ेगा, आगे आना पड़ेगा. और मैं मानता हूं समय बदल गया है, हमने भी बदलना चाहिए. और अगर हमने देश को बदलना है, सबसे पहले तो अपने आप को बदलना पड़ेगा. इसलिए इस तरह के एक भावनात्मक जो एक नेगेटिविज्म होता है, नकारात्मक भावना जो होती है, उसमें से, उस परिदृश्य में से बाहर आकर के सकारात्मक सोच के साथ, एक पॉजिटिव सोच के साथ आगे कदम रख करके ये सोचना होगा कि हमने चीजों को बदलना होगा. वी विल हैव टू चेंज द कोर्स ऑफ इवेंट्स एंड फॉर दैट वी नीड टू टेक स्ट्राइड्स बाय टेकिंग फर्स्ट द बेबी स्टेप्स एंड देन द बिग स्ट्राइड्स. एंड आई बिलीव सपनों को देखते रहिए, नहीं तो क्या होगा, जो ही स्वप्न देखेगा उसी के स्वप्न तो साकार होंगे, जो स्वप्न नहीं देखे उसका क्या साकार होगा. थैंक यू.
थैंक यू सो मच रघु साहब. नाउ लेट मी गो टू आवर यंग ब्लड ऑफ कश्मीरी पंडित कम्युनिटी, प्राउड ऑफ यू सुमित पील साहब. नाउ टेल मी दिस आर्टिकल 370, दिस चेंज्ड द एंटायर माइंडसेट ऑफ अस. इट इज गॉन. 2019 हिस्टोरिकल 5th August, इट डजंट स्टैंड. In this democratic process, it was gone. Why was it delayed? This is my question. Who kept it on and on? We know about it. And has this 370 and 35A now impacted us as a lag raha impact hai, par kahin nazar aa raha hai? Do you see a great hope after 370 and 35A going forward? Sumit Peel sir.
Bakshiji, the thing here is that what Modi ji had done in 7 minutes, I was on an English news channel, it was abrogated in 7 minutes. I tell you, the managing editor did not break the news for 10 minutes because he went and he said, let me talk to my legal, yaar ye hua nahi hua, main headline chala do, I might get into trouble. After his legal confirmed him, yes, it is done and dusted, he put on the stinger, he put on the headline, it is done. That was the power of the belief and that was the conviction of the political will. When you have the political will, you have the political charisma, yes, you always could have done it because people in the valley threatened you, khoon ki nadiya bahengi, tirange ko kandha dene wala koi nahi wala. Maine unko bola, tirange ko kandha dene wala 30 करोड़ लोग हैं, खून की नरियों से हमें मत डराओ, खून हमें डराता नहीं है, ये बहुत ड्रामा तुम्हारा हो गया, बिकॉज दैट you know will to do it is where the thing was, and that was done by Modi ji and Amit Shah ji, and what could not be done in 70 years, Bhakti ji was done in 7 minutes. Khatam, gayab. That is the power of conviction, that is the political will. Now what have we got? The first thing we have got is after 35A we have got our domiciles back, that we can claim our land, we have the right over the land, anybody can come and go and live in Kashmir, and even the POK refugees which needed a status, which needed a livelihood, have been given that after 70 years. They have suffered more than us. Now this feudum of few political dynasties who just thought ke Kashmir hamare baap ki varasat hai, ye mere father ki property hai, those dreams are shattered and they are now in dust. That is what we say. You can do ethnic cleansing at a point of time, but when the time will come, we'll turn the clock back. Turning the clock back is what we have done. And in aakhir mein bakshish jaate jaate ek kahunga, 65 saal ka kachra 7 saal mein nahi nikalta. Last ek cheez kahunga, bahut log aaye hamare tv pe, bahut log bahar ja suna hai, aur ye pakistani panelists aur kuch india mein bhi hai, bhai tumhari nasle mita denge, ye mita denge, unko maine ek hi cheez kehta hu, naslon ko mitane walon ki nasle nikal gayi, kuch to hai hamein ki mitti nahi hasti hamari, raha hai सदियों से दुश्मन दौरे जमा हमारा, कश्मीरी पंडित था है रहेगा, हजार साल बाद भी यही मिलूंगा, मैं नहीं मिलूंगा, स्पीक ऑफ माय डीएनए और वन ऑफ अस डीएनए विल बी टॉलर देन एवरेस्ट एंड ही विल स्टिल चैलेंज यू बिकॉज दैट लैंड बिलोंग्स टू मी, उस लैंड में मेरे पुरखों की मिट्टी है और वो मेरी है, थी है और रहेगी, लिव विद इट, अंडरस्टैंड इट एंड लिव एंड गेट इट स्ट्रेट इन योर हेड.
वेरी पावरफुल कुरेद के रख दिया. ये तालिबान खान सुन रहे होंगे, ये अब्दुल्लाह सैद ये सुन रहे होंगे. वी हैव लेस टाइम एंड आई हैव अ क्वेश्चन फॉर आईजीपी साहब. आईजीपी साहब, आई हैव दिस क्वेश्चन फॉर यू दैट डू यू रियली सी नाउ गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया एक्टिंग इन फेवर ऑफ कश्मीर एंड कश्मीरी पंडित्स? डू यू रियली सी अ डिफरेंस? क्विक रिस्पॉन्स फ्रॉम यू. होल साहब, यू हैव टू अनम्यूट. Call, sir. Do you really see a difference? You have to unmute, sir. I have to close in next 2 minutes.
Now you are hearing me.
Second question. Yes, sir. Please go ahead.
I feel there's a difference after the abrogation of 370 and 35A. But we would like, because that's basically for the government of India how to deal with terrorism and other things, because they could just enter inside and they are addressing the problem from administrative, political, security level. But one problem with Kashmir is the day, basically the week which we are celebrating is for Kashmir genocide, for our Kashmiri Pandit genocide. How the secularism and democracy treated and how we are hounded out. What rectification is required there? That is to be addressed because the situation may improve. But can we go there and live in the same manner the way we are living there? And we are permanent stakeholders. We should not be ignored whenever there is any political dispensation. We should not be ignored. All parties were invited, accepting Kashmiri as if we are not. We are aborigines. Even if they are as a majority, they too have come from Kashmiri Pandits. We have a right there. We must go. And it will be definitely, when we go there, we'll see that there's a difference. Till then, we are just languishing outside. It will always haunt us this during
this month. Thank you so much, Kohl Saab.
Thank you. Jai Hind.
Thank you so much, Kohl Saab. We need to close the program. And before closing the program, some of the tangible things which I have come here as demand. Demand genocide. Tribunal to really make these Yasin Maliks and others, they should face the blame. And we should get our properties back. And we should be declared like Israel kind of situation. And our story should be fantastic. 30 seconds, each one of you as speakers, because now Subhi has already left and Vikram Sahab ko bhi program mein jana tha. Mere paas Ashwini ji hai, Subhit Peel Sahab hai and Kohl Sahab hai. 30 seconds, last point of view from you, Ashwini ji. 30 seconds. What is your final two demands? And second, how will you support GKPD mission? Because GKPD today has taken this mission as an organization to work with all the organizations in the countries to take this mission forward. How will you support GKPD and what are your two demands?
And 30 seconds. The fact of the matter is that this Kashmiri Pandit diaspora has been focusing on very important facets of the struggle. And I believe I am always with it, always with it. And moreover, I think now, one thing needs to be done, I have been pursuing that for the last so much of time, that is to get GKP registered as an NGO in the United Nations Human Rights Council. That I have been pursuing for the last so much of time, and I need everybody should focus on that. If that happens, many things will be done. Thank you very much. So kind of.
Thank you, sir. I go to Peer Sahab. Peer Sahab, aapki demands badi solid hai, clear hai, clear, concise and effective demands. 30 seconds mein, how will you support Global Kashmiri Pandit diaspora in the mission which we have taken?
Sir, I have one more demand which I've been making on the national TV, that Kashmiri Pandits need reservation. There should be some seats which should be earmarked for Kashmiri Pandits. If you can do for ST, ST, why not for Kashmiri Pandit? Why Kashmiri Pandit ne aisi kya galti ki? Humne sabse aisa hai. That's point number one. And about GKPD, sir, कहते हम चलते हम अकेले चले थे लोग चलते गए कारवां मिलता गया मैं तो ये मानता हूं सर जहां हम खड़े होते लाइन वहां से शुरू होती ये हमें दुनिया को बताना है दिखाना है और करके देना है और हम आपके साथ है बोलिए चलना कहां है
लव यू सर आईजीपी साहब कोल साहब 30 सेकंड्स व्हाट इज योर फाइनल व्यू हाउ विल यू सपोर्ट ग्लोबल कश्मीर पैराडाइज फोरम इन द मिशन
व्हाट I have been a part of this GKPD. We fully try to associate all the Kashmiri Pandits organizations which are scattered all around to give a common platform to the Kashmiri problem so that our voice is heard internationally and nationally also. So that our problem, it is not only problem of Kashmiri Pandits, it is how the minority in a democracy sector gets hounded out. That is to be addressed. That reservation for secure, that protection for such minorities is required by minority status and for nominating members of the legislature so that they can decide their issues, not by others who have no direct contact with our problems. We have peculiar type of problems. Thank you. Jai Hind.
Can I get 5 seconds?
Yeah, 5. Yes.
एक चीज बोलना चाहूंगा आपका इतना बड़ा प्लेटफॉर्म इंटरनेशनली हर जगह जाता है कश्मीरी पंडित आज ये घोषित करता कश्मीर किसी के बाप का नहीं है 130 करोड़ भारत का कश्मीर जान लो मान लो एंड लर्न टू लिव विद इट
लव यू सर फॉर दिस फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल लेट मी नाउ क्लोज द प्रोग्राम आई वुड लाइक टू थैंक ईच वन ऑफ यू अश्विनी चौगू साहब विद लॉट ऑफ रिस्पेक्ट्स पीर साहब विद लॉट ऑफ ग्रेट रिस्पेक्ट्स कोल साहब आईजीपी साहब सुबुई खान जी हु इज लेफ्ट शी वाज सिक And Vikram Singh Saab for a wonderful contribution to this webinar, which was very important for us and the first webinar of the series. I would like to thank all the attendees and the participants who have joined from different parts of the world and who are watching us. There have been huge amount of people watching us this evening, and some of them will be watching it later on. I would like to thank my volunteer group, be it Shafalika, be it Neerja, be it Virender Kohl, be it Utpal Kohl, be it Ash Rana, be it our Germany head, Ajay Chaudhary ji, and of course, Virender Kohl Saab, as well as the US team, which has done a lot of great work on Kashmir. But each one of the volunteers, we are all volunteers. Yahan koi president nahi, yahan koi vice president nahi hai, yahan koi secretary nahi, yahan koi treasurer nahi hai GKPD mein. Please understand this is a civil society moment. यहाँ सारे volunteer हैं और जब मैं Houston में land किया 6 बजे New Jersey से 6 बजे सुरेंद्र कोल जी मिले और next day 6 बजे तक मैं I walked with him for 24 hours and I saw the passion this man has got on volunteerism. अगर volunteerism सीखना है तो सुरेंद्र कोल साहब से सीखे. So I would like to thank each one of you for the contribution, each of the participants, each of the people behind it, and I would like to inform. That the series is on. 16 tomorrow is going to be the next seminar, which is Kahani Kashmir, which is Kashmir Files. And you will have two major players of this Kashmir Files. That is Vivek Agnihotri ji and Surinder Kohl sir. Ye do inke saath Deepak Jitshi ke saath rahenge. Aur ye program watch kariyega next hai. And this is Kahani Kashmir ki Kashmir Files. Please watch that. Thank you very much. Shivratri, good night. And Kashmiri Pandit, puri duniya mein chhaya hai. Bilkul theek baat hai, Peer Sahab. I love you and I am going to soon meet you. Thank you very much. Thanks.
Thank you.